another episode of the Bibliophile's Garden. Today we're working with Miss Zora. Hi, Zora. And Miss Zora's going to be doing a lot today. So she's going to be planting some peppers. We have banana pepper and a California Wonder pepper. California Wonder is a bell pepper, and banana pepper is a sweet pepper, plus some basil. She's going to be fertilizing, watering, and there's going to be two different types of fertilizer. So we'll be back and we'll catch up. All right, so Zora's planting, she's digging the holes for both of the pepper plants. And we have a game plan on how we're going to place it because we still need room in this raised bed for the other plants that are going to be added in a few weeks. Now Zora already had some organic granular fertilizer in the bucket. So there we go, she's going to mix it all together. How does it look, Zora?
Oh, good.
All right, so now you're going to put a little bit in each hole. You can put even more than that. Okay, now Zora's planting the California Wonder pepper. Oh, yeah, she's already done just about. So that's a type of bell pepper. They're really nice. When they're ripe, they're red, and they're sweet, and you can get a lot of produce off of it. So now she's gonna move on to these little bad boys, marigolds. Zora, have you ever noticed when people do gardens, they usually have a lot of marigolds in the garden?
Oh, yes.
Do you know why?
No.
Okay, that's more companion planting. If you do a garden, you should have marigolds because they help the soil. They keep the soil healthy and it helps your plants grow better. And then like the flower itself, it helps to repel some insects. So just a little marigold now. All right, we'll be back, everyone. Zora, do you remember what we planted over here?
Yes, potatoes.
Good job. We have red Pontiac potatoes and Yukon Gold. Does it look like the potatoes are growing?
Yes.
Yep, a lot. So what you're gonna do, now do you know potatoes are a nightshade, right? You know what a nightshade is?
No.
All right, those are those plants like tomatoes, peppers, potatoes. They're all in the same family, eggplants, they're nightshades too. With potatoes, we don't eat the plant part. Like if we ate the leaves or they'll kill you. So what part of the potato plant do we eat? The part above ground or below? Exactly. So when we want to fertilize the part below ground, if you can hold this for me, we're going to use this. It's not the fish fertilizer, but what's it called?
More blue.
Good. So this goes back to the NPK. Nitrogen, potassium, phosphorus? I think those three. Anyway, so it's those three numbers. So for Alaska, the fish one is 511. Five parts nitrogen, one part the other two. For this, what's the numbers on the front?
0, 10, 10.
All right, so we have more potassium and we have more phosphorus. I hope that's what it is. But those are the numbers when you wanna promote flower blooms or if you wanna promote the root, you wanna use a fertilizer like that. So the potato that we eat is below ground. So do we wanna promote leaf production or the root production? Exactly. So you're gonna be fertilizing with that today. Oh, Zora is fertilizing that. Looks like, you know, I think our basil seeds, they're gonna germinate. It's just been like cold, but now I think it's gonna heat up again. So they're gonna germinate. And the corn is still looking good, what's left of it. If y'all don't remember, the day after the ladies planted the corn, we had a hailstorm. And it survived the hail. So we appreciate this corn. It's honey and cream corn by Haas Tubers. So now she made a good observation. We're gonna cover the basil as well, only because it's transplanted and basil is also very sensitive to temperature. It really likes the hot weather. All right, Ms. Zora, you did a lot of great work today. And the garden is looking good. We're getting in the mold, folks. So until next time, you've been with the Bibliophile's Garden. Ciao.